Hi everybody, this is Tiziano, and today we are going to connect this with this. And now, what are those? This is an autopilot, compatible with Ardupilot or PX4 stack. And on this side, I have a Raspberry Pi 3. Now, there are tons of other companion PC that it might suit your application even better than this, you know, more powerful, but the Raspberry Pi 3 is a very good starting point because it's cheap and because it has a great support from the community. Back in the previous tutorial, we showed how easy it is to write a Python code that connects and controls an autopilot like this one. In order to simulate the autopilot and the drone, we use the software in the loop running on our Ubuntu virtual machine. But this time, we are actually doing the thing for real. So we are connecting this board where we are setting up the environment to this autopilot. In this tutorial, we're going to follow a step-by-step procedure that will get your Raspberry Pi ready for controlling your drone through your computer. And how are we going to do that? First of all, we're going to download and install the operating system. In our case, it will be a Raspbian Lite, but it could be also Ubuntu. And if you like, there is a link in the description below. Then after having activated SSH on the companion PC, and for that, we will need a monitor, a keyboard, and an Ethernet connection. We will move to my computer and we will do everything else remotely. In the end, we are going to download my repository, my GitHub repository. We are going to modify one of the scripts that we developed for a previous tutorial. And we are making those two boards talk together for real. Now, what is really amazing is that everything will happen without never attach another keyboard or screen to this board anymore, because we're going to do it everything with SSH and through shared folder. In the end, we're going to connect the Raspberry Pi to the autopilot using a USB cable, and then it'll be okay for our example. But for a real application, I really suggest you use the telemetry port on the autopilot following these schematics over here. You got it? Okay. Now, if you're excited, you can follow me in the next tutorial. We start off by downloading the Raspbian Lite from the raspberrypi.org website. Then we put a micro SD card in the computer and we use a tool for format the SD card. In our case, SD formatter 4. And we're gonna be using Win32 disk imager for writing the image onto the SD card. Then you connect a monitor, a keyboard and a mouse, and then you power it up. When it's ready, insert Pi as a login and Raspberry as a password. We open raspi-config and we activate SSH. Then we reboot and on our computer, we open PuTTY on Windows and we insert pi at raspberrypi.local as the address. Open the raspi-config menu, then we set the local time. In my case, is the central. Then we activate the camera, interfacing option camera. Then it's very important that we select interfacing option and we go to serial and we disable the serial login shell. Plus, we wanna activate the hardware serial. Then we reboot. Now we're gonna run a sudo apt-get update and then a sudo apt-get upgrade. That it'll take a long time, so be patient. Now let's set up the Wi-Fi connection. Edit the file wpa-supplicant.conf, and here you set up your network with the SSID, your password, and also the priority in case you have multiple Wi-Fi available. And then scan SSID as 1 in case your SSID is hidden. Now we want to increase the swap memory to 1024. So we added the diffis swap file, and we set conf swap file to 1024, Control X and save it, and we reboot the service. Now we activate the X11 tunneling. Let's modify the file /etc/ssh/hd_config, and here X11 forwarding yes, X11 display offset 10, X11 use local host yes. Now we're gonna install Samba for easy install folder sharing management. So we sudo apt-get install Samba and Samba common bin. Then we're gonna create a shared folder. Let's create a directory drone, and then we modify the Samba config file. First of all, we're gonna set up Win support yes, then we're gonna set the netbios name as Raspberry, and then the workgroup name is workgroup in our case. In the end, we are gonna set up the shared folder. We create a Pi drone shared folder. We set the path as home Pi drone, and then we set browsable and writable. Now we set the Samba password, with SMB password, and we're gonna put Raspberry and confirm it. Now we can browse on our Windows machine. Here we go, we find Raspberry Pi, and here we set Raspberry Pi slash Pi, and then our password that is Raspberry. Now we're gonna set up the serial port. First of all, let's list our serial ports, TTY star, and here is TTY AMA0. So we modify the file boot config.txt. If you haven't seen TTY AMA0 before, you just set enable UART is equal to 1. And then we want to set the UART connection at very high speed because the autopilot can go as fast as 1.5 megabit per second. So let's set the clock to 64 million. Now we install pip. Pip is very important for installing Python libraries. Then we install Python dev, then future. Now we're gonna install screen, wxgtk, matplotlib, opencv, numpy, libxml, and libxslt. Those are important for compiling and running DroneKit later. Now let's be sure that we have the Python serial package. Now we install Git. Now that we have Git, we're gonna clone the DroneKit repository and we're gonna compile the library on the Raspberry Pi. I found that this method works much better than just installing DroneKit library because it saves a lot of headaches in case you have multiple connections. So I strongly advise you recompile DroneKit in your machine. After everything is done, we're gonna clone my How Do Drones Work repository in the folder drone. We're gonna copy the script number 3 to a new folder called My Script, and we rename it to Task Connection. And now we're gonna modify it. Of course, we're gonna modify the file on our Windows machine using the editor that you like. In my case, I'm gonna use Notepad++. Here it goes. We're gonna delete the software in the loop calling. And then we are gonna set the connection string as TTYACM0 for a USB connection. But in case you wanna connect with a serial port, you're gonna use TTYAMA0. And then the baud rate connection that for the USB is 115 and 200. Be sure that you set the proper baud rate even on your autopilot when you wanna connect it. In the end, we just run it on the PuTTY. So we connect the Raspberry Pi with a USB cable. And then we just run the file. And here it goes, it connects and it works like in my example. So now that we have our companion PC up and running, we can have serious fun. Now in the next videos, we are gonna probably set up other boards, and for sure, we're gonna do a video about setting up even a companion PC with computer visual libraries like OpenCV, and we're gonna be using them for, I don't know, object tracking, navigation, I don't know, you suggest. But for now, I'll thank you for watching. I wish you all a Merry Christmas, and I'll see you next year. Bye.